Today I'm going to show you how to shoot and edit a simple whip transition using your smartphone and the KineMaster video editing app. And it's a lot easier than you think. And before we jump into this, there are a couple things that you need to keep in mind when shooting for this sort of transition. Number one is everything is about movement. You want to cut it on the movement, which I'm about to demonstrate once I open the KineMaster app. So wherever you want the whip transition to go, be it at the beginning of the clip or the end of the clip, you're going to have some sort of movement so we can edit on the movement. For example, if you're recording and you want to come down at the end of a clip and whip down, then the next clip that you start recording with, you're going to hit record and then you're going to swing down and start speaking or filming whatever it is you're going to do on the camera. And though it's not necessary, it does kind of help if you're in the same color range when you end and begin your clip. For example, if I'm filming like this and I pan down, and say I pan down and the color is blue, well, if I can pick up on something blue and then swing down, that transition is gonna go together a lot easier than if I pan down to blue and then I pick it up in red. However, that could look cool. It depends on how you put it together. So see what works for you. Now let's open up KineMaster and let me show you how this is done. So when you open up the KineMaster app, the first thing you wanna do is click on the plus icon here to the left. And then over here on the far right, you're gonna see the media folder up on top. We're gonna tap on that and we're gonna go find the clips that we wanna edit. Let's do this one and do this one. And I'm just tapping on the clips and it's loading them up right there in the KineMaster timeline. As I put my thumb down and I scroll back and forth, you can see where the clips are. Now this is really easy. I'm gonna double tap on the clip and it's gonna pull up the clips and you can see right here what's happening as I scrub right back and forth. And where you wanna cut the clip is when the clip has the most movement. So right about there, when everything starts to blur, that's where I wanna cut it. So if the tools are not showing, just tap on the clip and you're gonna see the tools pop up here on the right. I'm gonna click on trim and split. Now I wanna get rid of everything to the right of this clip here. So I'm gonna trim to the right of the playhead. And that disappears. So what I have is the clip and then blur, and then the next clip starts. And I want to do the same thing. I want to find movement. Now I don't have a lot of movement in this clip, but we're going to try it anyway. I'm going to go right there. I'm going to tap on it and I'm going to clear everything to the left because I don't want that footage. And it's only going to trim out left of that clip. So now I have the two clips edited. I'm going to put my thumb on it and I'm going to just slowly scrub through to see if I'm happy with the cut. Now, if you go slowly, that doesn't look so good. So I'm going to back it up just a little bit and I'm going to hit play.
Actually make that work inside of your video editor. So if you notice for that...
Okay, that actually wasn't that bad. And you can see how easy this is. When I ended the first clip, I simply moved the camera so I had movement. And then when I started the second clip, I did the same exact thing, but I brought the camera down the other way to continue the movement. Okay, and it really is that easy. Just remember to cut where you have motion blur, put them together, and you're gonna be good to go. And if you have any questions or comments regarding this technique or the app or anything about this video, leave a comment down below. I read every single question. And as you know, I answer as many of them as I can. And when this video's over, I'm gonna go down there and carry on the conversation. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. If this is your first time here, be sure to hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell so you do not miss anything and you can continue to learn how to master your mobile and make cool transitions like this. And I'll see you in the next video.